Alright, hello everyone, welcome back to Let's Play with a Zelda Twilight Princess. I am SIMSteven, also known as Master Fenrel. And today we'll be doing a bunch of side questing stuff, so no story progress, and probably also be from the next episode as well. But today we're going to primarily focus on Poe Souls, since this is now available to us and we can warp all over the place to get them. So, I'm going to start here, since this is where we left off last time, and then I'm going to try and, you know, do it by area. So, whatever makes the most sense, I suppose. So, there's one over here, just outside of where the fishing hole was from the last episode. And I went right through for whatever reason. But yeah, we're just going to be hunting these things down. And, we're going to be hunting Poe Souls at night. And we're going to be doing mini games during the day, because for the most part, Poe Souls can only be collected at night because the Poes themselves only appear at night. So, I'm going to grab that one, and I think we should actually stay in wolf form and go back into Zora's domain, since I am using a guide for this, and I'm going to pretty much stick to going by area. And there are a couple over in the Zora's domain. It's already kind of dawn already, so we're not going to get too many this episode, or at this point in time. We're just going to have to wait till night falls again before we can really start collecting them. But I'll try and grab the two here inside Zora's domain. I'm kind of swimming upriver here, and it's not going to be easy. I might be able to destroy that rock up there with the bomb, but I'm going to swim against the current. So, hopefully I'll be able to get the two that are here. If not, we'll come back and make this our first stop once night falls again. Because, unfortunately in this game, there is no sun song. Like, there is an Ocarina of Time, or there is no melody of the sun or whatever, like in Wind Waker. I forget what the name of that particular song was called, but... there's no way to magically change day into night, night into day, like there are in other games. You just have to wait it out. Fortunately, there are only a handful of things you can do during the night. What I really should say is there are only a handful of times where you actually need to be a certain time of day in order to do certain things. So getting like the Poe Souls is one of those things that requires it to be a certain time of day. For the most part, though, you're pretty much good. Can we warp from over here? There was going to be one over here, but apparently dawn has broken already. Yeah, we wasted most of last night just hanging around the fishing hole. So, actually, you know what? That's actually that will be a good spot for us to go to next, because, like I said, we're going to be doing some mini games here, and we're going to pay a return visit to Iza now that we've gotten the river to flow for her so she can run a little boating business. And I probably will cover the fishing hole in probably its own episode, because I'm probably going to go over all the fish she can catch and the extra hard one that takes a lot of effort to catch. So, that will probably take a good long time to go over when we get to it. So, instead, we're going to do much simpler mini-games, ones that don't take as long to get all the rewards from. And really, the fishing hole, there isn't really a whole lot to get in terms of rewards and stuff. We got the piece of heart that was on the rock at the end of the last episode, and that's really the good thing, the best thing you can get out of that, aside from, well, the bottle on the side, fishing hole. But for the rest of that, rest of the stuff you can do in the fishing hole, it's mostly for rupees and just for entertainment to, well, if you like the fish, well, that's kind of a fun thing to do. So either way, we're back here and we're talking to Iza here, and she recognizes us from last time. Hey, welcome. Thanks to you, we're back in business. Well, we can't offer much, but just make yourself at home. And of course, if you want a boat to ride, just let me know. I'm happy to rent you one. Hopefully it doesn't cost too much, because I'm a little short on rupees right now. Oh, that's perfect. I have just enough for that. All right, I don't think I'll need a guide or anything like that, but we're going to do this little mini game here now that we've gotten the river flowing once again. And as you can see, we've got a little thing on the bottom right-hand corner of the screen, and the little Zora part-timer girl is kind of hanging out in front of us. I believe she will drop rupees for us, but that's not what we're here to get. Instead, we're going to try and increase the number on the bottom right as much as we possibly can. It's not a problem right now if we hit the walls, but now that we've scored a point, anytime we hit a wall, our score will decrease. However, you don't really have to worry about this too much. The river's flow will carry you along pretty well. And so all we gotta do is try and hit these pots as we flow down the river. Just take it nice and easy. Try and counter steer when you don't see any pots hanging off the ceiling or anything like that. And then, for the most part, just try and face forward as much as possible. And we're gonna try and get a high score. I don't remember exactly the score you need to get the best item. It's probably gonna be a piece of heart or something. But you definitely want to hit the red ones, because they're worth 2 points? I think that's what it was. I'm just looking at the bottom screen. I thought I'd jump from 5 to 7. But yeah. You want to score as many of these pots as you can. There's a bunch of them. And this is also the reason why you wanted to bust the debris that's on your way the first time around, because it'll stay busted. For what do you do this? And it won't reduce your score. Just barely hit that one. There's a bunch of these pots sitting on these little rocks here. Hit that one, hit that one. Alright, 3 in a row. Yeah, I'm doing pretty good with the score. Just really don't have to steer much. Just kind of steer so you don't hit the walls. Because once again, your score will go down if you hit the walls. But for the most part, the river will take you where you need to go. Just avoid that! Oh, almost. And... Oh! Yeah, I didn't bust that one last time. Missed that. Got you. Yeah, pretty much gotta aim in the middle. Don't try and, you know, lead your shots too much. Just try and get the right height as best as you can. And try and hit them, keep it in the middle of the screen whenever you let go. I'm glad I cleared most of the debris there, because we're doing really good here. I think you actually need like 20, maybe 25 points to get the best item here of this minigame, which I think is going to be a piece of heart. And there's a lot of pots right here at the very end. So, got you. I missed a couple. 25, that should be plenty, and we're here at the end. I only missed a couple pots and hit a couple walls. I think 20 is all you need to get, but maybe 25 just to be sure. But I'm pretty sure I did it. I mean, I didn't really miss that many opportunities for points and all that, so we should be good, I hope. And we get to talk with the little cute Zora girl once again. She is kind of cute, by the way. Thanks for your patronage! On this trip downriver, you scored 25 points! That's a pretty good mark to hit. Congratulations, it's the first customer to score at least... Well, I guess 25 is all we needed. You receive this prize, the giant bomb bags. Ooh, even better than a piece of heart. So, now our bomb bags hold twice as many bombs as before. Really good upgrade to get. And, speaking of bomb bags, there's actually one back for us in Zora's domain. But that's just it. We landed right here at the southeast side of Zora's domain. And right here where this hawk rest is, there's a little... I did not mean to pick that up. Hi there, Mr. Little Parrot Dude. Oh, a human. I'm Plumm. But I don't need to talk to humans. So what, can I transform into a wolf right in front of you? Wow. He doesn't care.
Hello, hello, hello. I am Plumm.
I'm really excited about the latest attraction down here at the lake. Want to hear about it? Sure. The attraction is all about popping balloons as you move toward the goal. It's stupendous. Balloons are worth different amount of points. Watermelon, one, orange, three, and strawberry, 10. Only if you break the same type of balloon twice in a row, you get double the points, but only up to 10 times. If you hit a wall and fall off, then you get no points. That's right, 0 points for you. First, B to start over from the beginning. You know, if you get something neat, if you get over 10,000 points, right? Not that you ever will. Well, that sounds like a challenge to me, so... I guess all we gotta do is howl out the hot grass song once again. And thankfully this doesn't cost me anything, not that I would expect the bird to have anything to do with the rupees. I mean, I don't think he really has a use for them after all. So, we're just gonna fly right back up into the Zora's domain and play this other little mini game that's right here where the rafting mini game drops us off at. We'll be able to fly back up, kind of like we did back when we dispelled Twilight from this realm. Only this time, this bird is not plagued by Twilight. And we have to actually get to see what he looks like in the real world. Alright, so, let's do this little mini-game here. Thankfully, it's free once again. I need to go grab myself some bugs and take them to Agatha's. Speaking of which, we did see a couple back in Zora's domain, but I'm pretty sure I got those before. I'm not 100% sure myself on that one, but either way, for this game, you want to start off hitting these oranges, and eventually you'll see some watermelons. Oops. Oops, I flew too high. Didn't I do that before when I was trying to get the tears of light? I thought I hit my head on the ceiling there a couple times. Crap. Oh well. I guess we're going to have to start this over. Well, I guess we have to see what happens if we fail. That was so lame. Yes, it was. Want to go again? Sure. Thankfully, we don't have to do the howling thing all over again. We just get to go right back into it. And once again, it's a free ride. So let's do this again and not bump our head on the ceiling. So get a couple points there. And doubles. I almost did it again. That's a very narrow thing to hit, and I don't want to hit the water either because that means we'll, you know, get dragged off down with the current. But what you want to do here is ignore everything once you start hitting strawberries. Just hit nothing but strawberries. Don't bother dashing, just take it nice and easy. There is no time limit on this, as you can see. And just hit strawberry after strawberry after strawberry. And flip that one. Don't hit the watermelon. Don't hit the watermelon. And just combo strawberries. And see, my score is multiplying like crazy here now. And if you just keep hitting strawberries, since they're worth 10 points normally, and keep doubling and tripling your score. See there, I almost had it there. I got 5,000 points. Oh, where did I hit that last one? Crap, wow. I had the 10,000 points, but you gotta make it through the course in order to get it. So, we're gonna try again, and hopefully I'll get it this time. I'll let you listen to the music next time around and just shut up. So, it's kind of a fun little circus tune to listen to, but yeah, let's just do this until I get it right. Oh, And I literally blew that score out of the water. Woohoo! I almost had 50,000 points, almost five times what he was expecting to get. And he thought 10,000 was a little too high. But I got 46,094 points! What? No way! You got more than 10,000 points. Wow, here, take this. But don't think I'm giving you this because I like you or you think, what, are you a Sundre too? So we got ourselves yet another piece of heart, and that's five for another full heart container. Woohoo! You're completely hooked now, aren't you? You need to go again. No, thanks. I completely blew your expectations out of the water. Wait, is it already dusk already? Well, that's good news. We might go pole hunting after all. A lot sooner than I was expecting, too. So, well, first, though, we're going to go back into Zora's domain. And we're going to try and... Well, first of all, we're going to check to see if we can actually collect the bugs or not. I don't remember if I got them before. Can I destroy this thing or not? I'm going to check that out as well. It looks very suspicious, if you ask me. So, let's get some of our bombs out of our expanded bomb bags. Alright. And... Nope. Guess not. Alright, well, let's get that off there. I don't like to accidentally use my bombs unless I'm actually intending to blow something up. So, let's get back into the Zora's domain here. We're going to put out our Zora's armor here. Actually, you know what? I'm going to switch back into wolf form. And we're going to go to the top of the waterfall first. Well, maybe... No, can't do it here. We're not out of sight here. Might as well have to do it here. We're going to warp to the top and then work our way down because there's something important at the top over in the throne room. Alright, so we can transform over here. And then we can warp. Because, like I was saying before, after we did Iza's little rafting game, there's actually a bomb bag here. It's actually the third one we can get, and I don't know if we can get the third type of bomb from Barnes's shop just yet, but we can at least use it for extra bomb storage if we need it. So, I'm going to go out here, because I don't think there's any people over here, so we can transform safely at the top of the waterfall here. And from here, we're going to go back down and use our iron boots to drop into... Where we dropped that molten lava rock earlier when we saved the Zora's people back when the Twilight was here. Actually, hold on a sec. I'm going to check one thing out real quick. I could have sworn there was a treasure chest. Oh, wait. In order to get that treasure chest appear, I think I actually need to light a couple torches here real quick. So we're going to do that first. Lantern. That's almost out of oil. So, light that one. Get on this little platform here. And jump over here. Light this one. And there it is. That's the treasure chest I was thinking of. It'll actually appear down the water. And you need both the Zora tunic. Well, actually, I don't think you need the Zora's tunic. You just need the iron boots, which you should have by now. But it makes it easier to have the Zora's tunic so you don't have to worry about your air. And we'll be able to go grab this purple ruby. So if we need more money for mini games, you got some. And we're going to swim down to the bottom. And we're going to take our water bombs and blow this rock open. You might have also noticed that there was a little arrow there for half a second when we inside of the rock. And, well... Inside the rock, there was actually a gourd. Remember, this thing came from Death Mountain originally. And apparently this guy... Well, he'll explain it to us here. I'm finally out! Thanks, brother! I took a nap and found myself swallowed up in lava, and somehow very far from home. Say, brother, do not swim off. I have yet a chance... have not had a chance to thank you yet. All right, so if you don't have your iron boots equipped, he'll say that. Here, take this with my thanks, brother. It's all I have with me right now. I hope it will do. So we got ourselves a bag with bombs. I think it just comes with normal bombs normally. but yeah, there is that. So we got ourselves three bomb bags and expanded bomb bag. Double the size of bomb bags in one episode. So very worth your time to do the quests and the side quests and the mini games up here in the Zora's Domain. Now one other thing I would like to mention that I would like to correct here is, first of all, I should say these are the last, these are the only three bomb bags in the game, and that double bomb bag upgrade is the only other bomb grade, the only upgrade you'll get for them. So our bomb bags are at max. This is all we can hold currently. So if we have water bombs, we can hold up to 30. A bag full of normal bombs can go up to 60, and the third type of bomb we'll go over later. Now, the thing I want to correct from the last episode is I said the fourth bottle will take us a very long time to get. Well, actually, I was wrong. There is something that will take a long time to get, but that requires 60 Poe Souls. However, if you get 20 Poe Souls, the one goal that Giovanni wanted us to get first, he'll give you the fourth bottle. So that's the main thing you want to get from all the first 20 postals. Now, there are some rubies down here. I'll probably come grab them later. But because it's nighttime, I want to hurry things up and get some more postals so we can get ourselves that... so we can get ourselves that bottle and pretty much have all of our extra storage stuff maxed out. So we can carry pretty much anything. So we're going to transform the wolf. I don't remember if there is a Poe Soul here in the throne room. I'm going to look it up here really quick. No, actually, I remember it. There are actually two here in the waterfall area and one near the mini-game area with the fishing hole and the rafting. So this is the other... I'm going to try and get this one here because, like I said, once night falls again, we're going to go back over here. So, over here on the east side, there's normally one of these little dragonflies here. I'm going to go try and pick it up here and see if I actually have these or not. Pretty sure I grabbed these earlier. Oh, no, I didn't. I didn't grab the dragonflies. So, we got the mail here. And there is a postal up here. Once again, these guys only appear at night. So that's why this guy wasn't here before. And usually the way I just take these out is use the A button, jump attack. The B button is kind of worthless against these guys. And it does less damage. But two hits with the jump attack is usually enough to take them down. And once they're on the ground, you just rip the soul out and that's it. So, if you transform back into human, I think the other dragonfly is going to be right here in the middle of the pond here. I did not mean to swim down. But I think back when we were here, when we were dispelling the Twilight, there was a bunch of lily pads, I think, in the middle here. Isn't that where the other dragonfly is, or not? No, it doesn't look like it. I think he's probably up higher than... and we'll have to do some minion jumping. I keep accidentally swimming down because I want to move faster. So the way we're going to fix that is put on our hero clothes again so he doesn't actually die down below. Yeah, I have to go this way if I want to actually get... back in the wolf form, because the other Poe is going to be up on the cliff there that we have to do some mini jumping to get to. And of course, if we're going to grab the Poe Soul, we have to be Wolf Link. So we need to be transform into wolf once again and make our way back up the mountain. Alright, so we're going to. In wolf form. Go back up the mountain here and try and find that pole. Jump. Go up a little bit. I think I actually see them right there. A little glint over there. And we're going to look for the... Actually, hold on. I remember where the other dragonfly is now. It's actually back over by Isa's boat shop. So, did I have that one? No, I don't have that one. So, we're going to go grab that on our way out. And we're going to go do a bit more pole hunting. After that. And your soul is mine! Not joking around. Let's get out of here. What's that? Oh, that's just a blue rupee. I thought it was in like another Poe or Dragonfly or something. No, that was just a blue rupee sitting on the cliff. I was wondering what that glowing thing was. Anyways, we can make a quick stop over here to grab the dragonfly. And then we can start our hunt for the Poes all around Hyrule Field. And we might also get some bugs while we're out there too. So we can give them to Agatha and make a fortune. Let's see here. I could probably blow that rock up and get some rupees out of it. I'll do that later. I'll worry about that kind of stuff more during the day, and I'll probably cover as much of that as I possibly can. I'm going to try and be as thorough as possible when it comes to secrets and hidden stuff, so yeah, we're going to try and get all that stuff later. Just hanging out there. Once again, the Gale Boomerang is probably the best thing you can use to get these bugs, and he's going across that way. Okay, so you're not running away from me, Mr. Bug. He's going back the other way. He's being a bit hard to catch. Come on, come on. There we go. Come to me, come to me. Okay, get close, get close. There we go. So we got the female dragonfly. And I think at this point, we can warp out to, Hyrule Field. Now where would be a good starting point? Kakariko Gorge sounds like a good starting point to me. So we're going to start here, and I think we'll work our way around clockwise. That sounds pretty good to me. And we're going to hit Poe Soul after Poe Soul. Try to get them all in one or two nights. There's a lot of these things out there, 60 to be precise. And I think the first one is going to be over here to the southwest. And up this hill, if I'm not mistaken. I know there's one in the area to the west, but I'm pretty sure there's one in this section of the world too. If not, I'll probably just pause and kind of follow along, you know, area by area, and look at a guide and try and figure out where all these are, because I remember where most of them are, but I don't remember where all of them are, and it's kind of worth looking at a guide. I probably could easily hit 20 on my own, just kind of going about things normally, but for, you know, kind of guide purposes and let's play purposes, I want to keep it, you know, compact and try to limit the amount of searching around that I have to do. Oh, there's one. There he is. He's at the top of the hill, just above the bridge that we fixed earlier. And two. Here we go. There's another. How many we got, by the way? I forget. Eight. So we're almost halfway there. And one other thing I should mention is that the game automatically gives you 5 Poe Souls. So, if you want the extra bottle, which is the only worthwhile reward you get from Giovanni, you know, you want to get the first 20 Poe Souls or so, you know, all you need to really get are 15 on your own, and you can skip the last 40 if you feel so inclined, because the reward at 60 is not all that great. I'll just put that out right here now. It's halfway decent, I would say, but by the time you're able to get it, the game is pretty much over. And yes, you're going to be hunting these things down to the very end of the game. If you're going for all 60, that is. And we saw one there, but daylight came a little too fast. So we missed out on that one. So instead, let's go bug hunting, I suppose. Now, the ones puzzles we got before this, I probably should go over. There's one over here in the fog area, and that's the one I already mentioned, you know, you can get before the game actually introduces you to Poe Souls. And so, yeah, just need to jump from here, go along to here, and when you're in the tree stump area in the middle, that's where the Poe Soul is. I got that one way back when we were still trying to dispel the Twilight from the second area of the game, the Elden Province for Kakariko Villages, and that's before we reunited with the kids and all. So that was a long time ago when we took care of that. So yeah, that's there. That's where we had our first one. The second one we got was when we went with, you know, Minna through Giovanni's house to meet Zelda for the second time. That was just 2 episodes ago, so they've been far and few between because the game hasn't officially introduced us into that one in Giovanni's house. Now, the one in Giovanni's house is unmissable. You have to get that in order to proceed with the game, otherwise he will not open that treasure chest to give you access to where the sewers, which is where we need to go to save Minna and all that, meet Zelda. So that was all before we got the Master Sword, which we just did in the last episode. In the next dungeon of the game, there are actually 4 Poe Souls, and those are the other 4 that are required to get to proceed with the game. Aside from that, there are 15 you need to get the bottle. And we're here above the bridge of Hyrule, or the Lake Hylia Bridge. I believe there are a couple bugs here, and this is where we're going to start a bug hunt. Now, one thing over there, we beat up a bunch of chews along the way. And I was hoping for a rare spawn, because sometimes you'll get a rare chew there. And there, whenever you defeat a rare chew, if you scoop it up in your bottle, it'll actually give you a full heal, and I think it'll also boost your attack power until you get hit once. So it's basically the soup that you get, Grandma's soup from Wind Waker. Only it works one time, that's it. And it's a very strong boost, I suppose, for when you are in a tight spot or want to beat a boss really quickly. So it's a very good healing item, as well as it boosts your attack. Now, I swear there was a bug on the side of the bridge. I could be wrong. And once again, the bugs are a lot easier to spot during the night, but we're going to be doing Poe hunting during the night, so... Usually the bugs here on this bridge are hanging off the big tall pillars. I know I'm looking in the right general area. There's one around here somewhere. I remember there being one on the north side of the bridge and one on the south side. Maybe he's on the rocks down here, just a little bit farther past. Could be remembering things just slightly wrong. So we're going to look around here. I know there is one here, and they always come in pairs, so... Where are you, Mr. Bug? You know what? We'll come back to him when the darkness starts to come back in. Because I swear there's one around here somewhere. And let's stop rolling around here. Let's actually dash around and go for him. Across the bridge. I know there's one on this side of the bridge near the pillar area here. So we'll get this one real quick. Yeah, there's one right there. I see him already. First, we gotta take out this bald one. And you're dead. Alright, so I see you there. And I actually hit the wrong button. There you go. Locked on. Bring you close by. There we go. So we got ourselves a mantis. And I believe that's the male. I believe the female, once again, is on the south side somewhere, but we'll have to try and find her later, I guess. We got a rock there. Why don't we bomb that? Because usually you can get rippies out of these rocks that are just hanging around in her field. And speaking of rupees, there's a big treasure chest right nearby. One we can actually get, and one there's also another one we can't get until much later. There we go. Let's lob it over there and get it over there. So yeah, whenever you bust these big rocks hanging around the Hyrule field, you can usually get a bunch of rupees out of them. So easy money if you ever see one just hanging around and you got time to spare. Just toss a bomb at it. We're gonna get a treasure chest here. This is optional, and I think in the HD remaster, this is actually a stamp for Miiverse posting. But you grab onto this vine here and climb up here and slowly walk to the ledge here until Link just barely falls off. Shimmy over to the right. And there should be a I gotta keep going. Keep going to the right. There should be a treasure chest here with some rupees in it. Once again, I believe in the Wii U HD remaster, this thing actually has a stamp for if you want to post on Miiverse. And that's one of the more well-hidden treasure chests in the game. There's actually one way back down to the south area, which I think we're getting close to dusk soon, so we could probably go grab that one too. Get that once we get the claw shot, which is again another reason why I want to save a lot of the side questing until after we beat that temple, because there's a lot of stuff hanging around once you get the claw shot. Take one last look around here. If not, I got a good idea where it might be, and I'm pretty sure it's either in here underneath this giant tree. Is that the Deku tree, by the way? I'm not entirely sure. There is no Deku tree in this game, from what I remember, but that's the closest thing I can think of to being something as big as the Deku tree in this game. And yes, the Deku tree is something of a repeating thing, or a recurring character. Kind of character, if you want to call it that. It's a tree, for freaking sake. So, it's something that it comes back pretty much every Zelda game, but I don't think it's this game, oddly enough. So, either way. I heard a jingle. Oh, there you are. I knew you were around here somewhere. Somewhere on the south side of the bridge. And here it is. Knock on and ring it in. Once again, you don't actually need the claw shot to get all the bugs. Just need the Gale Boomerang and bring them to you. And let's head back to the south part of Hyrule Field and grab the Poe there that we were just unable to get before. Also, I'll actually say this for later, but there are some rocks up there that you can hit with bomb arrows, and they'll reveal a hookshot target. I believe there's a hidden cave up there, which leads to a piece of heart. We'll get that later, because right now, we need to dash down to South Hyrule Field. And try and grab that, get to the Poe in time to grab the soul. Actually a ledge you can jump off if you're riding Epona, which is kind of weird because I'm not really even using Epona because the wolf is decently fast, and oddly enough, even though the Hyrule Field is pretty huge in this game, you can actually traverse it pretty fast just as Wolf Link or as Human Link, so it's really not as big as it seems when compared to the first time you come out here to Hyrule Field. So yeah, it's one of the smaller Hyrule Fields in... I don't know if I would say that. It's not really that small. I mean, it's pretty big for its time, but especially in comparison to something like Breath of the Wild, Yeah, this is a pretty small Hyrule field. Okay, kill the bird. Now this is that treasure chest I wanted to get that I was talking about a second ago. There is, as you can see, there's a hookshot target under the bridge here. And if you hookshot over to it, there is actually a treasure chest here. You can grab it. Grab probably another 100 rupees, I believe. Yep. So, I believe that's also a Miiverse stamp in the HD remaster. So, are there actually, no, Beaverse doesn't exist on the Wii, so what am I thinking? That's probably something they had planned, because this was a dual release on the Wii and the GameCube initially, and that's probably also another reason why they wanted to do the HD remaster, because they could probably add things that they had planned, but didn't really get a chance to really flesh out during the Wii's lifespan, I suppose. Wow. I got hit during the animation, but I still got the Poe Soul. That was kind of a weird glitch, Mr. Bird. Anyways, we got that Poe Soul, and if there's like a cave you can dig down to, I believe it's over here. I'm not going to worry about that right now. Once again, I'm going to get the Poe Souls that are here on the world map. So, I believe the next one is this way. I believe there's also some kind of in the castle town area and up far north. But overall, we're just gonna kind of run as fast as we can, just kind of see what we can see along the way, I suppose. And hopefully, just spot them as we go. In fact, isn't there one up there on that ledge that I was talking about a second ago? I'm not totally sure. Yeah, there is one up there, so we're gonna grab him. Get our bone arrows out. Oh, I did not mean to hit that. Grab this one. But we'll come down. And shoot that rock. Let's grab our claw shot. And go up there. Well, can I get that? It's kind of hard to see here, because it's nighttime and it's not showing up too well on the monitor, so... is the shot target there? I can't see it. I can't see a dang thing here, because it's too dark. I know I can get up there from somewhere around here. Just don't see the claw shot target. I know it's up there. It's somewhere. I just need to lock onto it from wherever. Is it here? Oh, well, there's a rock here. Let's blow that up. Get yourself some rupees. Your ruby, 10 rupees. And 10 rupees. Go away, you. I can't even see it. He's too far away. Once again, my monitor is a little dark, so forgive me if I can't really see what the crap here. There's a Poe up there, and I can see you there, but can't get to you because I can't see the freaking claw shot targets. I know you gotta go up around. I know it's up there, I know you're there, I just can't get to you for whatever reason. Is there a rock up there I still need to blow up? Not entirely sure. I saw something blow up, I think. Can't get up there, can't get up there, because I can't freaking see! Or do I need to start there and go across? I don't really remember. Help! I can't see. Where are you? Oh, there it is. There it is. I can see it now. Finally. I'm leaning forward because I can't actually see this dang thing. Oh, my recording stopped. I knew this was going to be a problem at some point. There we go. There we are. And there's a rock we blew up just a second ago. I can see the claw shot target there. I gotta get forward a little bit. And there you are. Yeah, we're gonna spend this whole night just trying to get this one pole. Because it's hard to freaking see on my monitor. There you are. Let go. Immediately transform into wolf and not get ourselves knocked off this ledge. Let's go in the back here. one other thing I probably should mention, since we're talking about the HD audience a little bit, is I believe once you do the thing with Giovanni's house, when you're on the way to meet Princess Zelda, is I believe he'll give you a Poe lantern, something that they added to the HD remaster. And basically, it doesn't work like a lantern as you expect it would, but whenever you're... Well, it doesn't provide light like the other lantern we have works. It doesn't provide light, but if you're in an area where there's a Poe nearby and you pull out your Poe lantern, what that'll do is it'll actually light up. It'll do the little glowy glow like the Poes make whenever you're looking for one and not using your senses to see them. But it'll glow if there's ever a Poe nearby. So, yeah, that's just something to help you find Poes. It makes it a little bit easier, but I wouldn't really consider it to be that big of an improvement. But it's there for people who really want to do their Poe hunting. But anyways, we dug ourselves into that cave, or that was the little circle of grass, and there's actually a cave down below. Figure I might as well take care of it since we took forever just to get up to that ledge. And we're gonna kill these little skulls. Their official name is actually Bubble. So another enemy that's returned from the very first Zelda game. They weren't exactly... didn't really look like skulls back then, but kind of, sort of, I don't know. And I think you get a piece of heart if you kill them all. I completely blew off whatever that treasure chest was that was outside. Was that also an orange rippy? I don't remember. But I know one of these has a piece of heart, so we're going to grab that real quick. Oh, there's the orange rippy. I'm pretty sure the other one was a piece of heart, right? Actually, I don't have any piece of heart. Where is it? I sworn one of these treasure chests up here actually has a piece of heart, but... maybe I'm remembering things wrong? I don't remember. But let's take out our actual lantern, since we're on the subject of lanterns. And check to see if there are any treasure chests hanging around here. Because there usually are in these little caves. See a rock there. Put the camera on a little bit. And see if we can find any other treasure chests hanging out. Because there usually is, like, one or two in the grass if you... And they hide them pretty well, so... I guess not in this one. Could have sworn there was a piece of heart up here somewhere, but I guess I could be remembering wrong once again. And we probably did waste the entire night just trying to hookshot up to this one. Actually, no, it's still nighttime, so we still got a chance to get some more puzzles. You know what, I'm probably going to have to look up another guide for pieces of heart eventually, but that'll probably be more for the next episode. Transform into a wolf once again. Well, these trees are going to respawn, so I'm going to keep an eye out to see if maybe they're not going to respawn. Well, there's one. Keep an eye out for a rare shoe. It's possible to get one here. And it'll be white and glowy, so it'll be obvious. Oh, is that it? No, that's a skill. thought it was kind of. I thought I got lucky and got ourselves a rare chew here because I thought I saw something white and sparkly over there, but I guess not. Just another skeletal wolf. Alright, so let's get ourselves across the bridge here. Actually, I could, probably could just warp over to. Over by Camp. I can transform into Human Town. I could warp over to the portals to the left of Castle Town because I believe that's where our next Poe Soul is hanging out at. There's also going to be a couple bugs we can get here, so we'll try and grab those before the episode because we're already at 50 minutes already. This might take more than two episodes to cover all the side quests we could do right now, but. We're just gonna make a lap around Hyrule Field and try and get as much stuff as we can. I believe there's one down here in this little auditorium area. Oh, and there's also a bug there, so we'll grab that one in just a second here. I believe it's just a butterfly, it ain't going nowhere. So, yeah, there's a poke here. And get out of the way, bud. Wow, it takes you forever to get up. And I'm wasting time here. I did look at the guy that said there were like 8 of these around Hyrule Field, I think. Or was that the Gerudo Desert? Oops. I just kind of spoiled that, but we'll be going to the Gerudo Desert pretty soon, but yeah. This area, the Hyrule Field and the Gerudo Desert, there are more poles in these two areas than there are any other place in the game. Well, naturally, the Hyrule Field should be obvious because it's kind of like the single biggest area around. But also, the Gerudo Desert is the next area in the game we're going to be going to. And, well, because Poe's just got introduced, naturally there's going to be a lot of Poe's in there. And, well, if we're going to hit 60, we need at least one big area that has a bunch of Poe's. So why not a desert, after all? Kind of interesting, but yeah. Go north. We're probably gonna miss out on the Poe's here. Yeah, it's already dawn, so I know there's gonna be one on that bridge over there, because I don't remember it being there, but I'm gonna go back into human form. And grab the bugs here. And then go back to Castletown for a little bit. Although, we're probably not going to do much in Castletown for the time being, and save some more for the next episode. There should be a bug on one of these trees near the Southwest exit. Did we fly off? Oh, wait, Les Alphos. I saw something glinting over there. It's on one of these trees over here. Just which one is the question? That one. That one there. No, it's over here somewhere. Oh, there it is. And so, Peter Al or Hindi Dindi Yildi. Get out that tree. I think you're stag beetle, right? Yep, stag beetles. I remembered right. Because, well, I play a bit of Animal Crossing. And stag beetles are the easiest way to get money in that game. And naturally, they always hang off trees. Kind of how they do the same thing in Breath of the Wild when you need to grab those as materials for your armor and stuff. They're always hanging on trees for whatever reason. But regardless, I remember the next one is in here. Kind of in the middle of this rocky area, there's actually a hidden doorway here. And it'll be hanging on just off the top of the doorway here. See it there. I think we can actually blow that open, but we can't actually get the stuff that's inside there, so I'm not going to bother with it. We need a dungeon item from Future Dungeon to get the stuff that's in there, which I believe it's just a piece of heart, so. Yeah, just an easy piece of heart to get once we beat that dungeon, but that'll be a while before we get there. And the bug we're looking for should be just around that doorway there. See, we're kind of just south of the entrance to Zora's domain, so we kind of did make a full lap here. Not completely, because we haven't gone to the eastern field, but kind of explored that already. But I'm pretty sure the bug we're looking for is just on top of the there. I see the thing going off there, so yeah, there it is. Very hard to see. You probably couldn't see it. I just knew it was there because I remember it being there. So, female stag beetle. Let's double back to West Castletown. In fact, we can just warp there and keep accidentally transform the wolf. You can actually go straight to warp and then he'll transform into a wolf, but yeah, I was a little trigger happy there. So we're going to grab the butterflies here in this area, and that should be most of the bugs. I believe we'll be three short of having all the bugs at this point, once we get all of them here. But that should be close to a full completion, or a full collection, once we get all of these here. We got a lot of rupees as well, so we might just make a quick drop off when we get to the village, and get rid of all of our rupees there. Alright, so, male butterfly. Why am I always getting the male ones first? That's kind of weird. But the female butterfly is over here near the western exits, towards where Lake Hylia is. It should be up on that ledge. Once again, guides will like to tell you that you can only get these bugs like this one by grappling up there with your claw shot and getting the bug up there because it's up there. But once again, I do not need to do that. And this archer is getting on my nerves. Get out of here because I'm going to need to use some precision aiming here. Thank you for that. Should be a little patch of flowers up there. Should be able to just barely see it from the ground. And there should be a butterfly. It's kind of floating around up there. But I am here to prove the guide's wrong, and I'm not using my claw shot. and grab it from down here. Yeah, there it is. Oh, I almost had you. There we go, locked on. And there we go. So that should be all the bugs we can get for now. Still got a ways to go with the Poe Souls, but that's just something we'll have to do throughout the course of the game. Yeah, like I was saying before, we're going to be going to the Gerudo Desert soon, and that's where you get these two. And then there's the other snail, which is going to be near the Temple of Time, but we can't actually get it until we go back there later in the game. Once again, I mentioned this at the end of the last episode, after we got the Master Sword. But, we got ourselves about another 300 rupees here, 450, another 600 rupees worth of bugs, so, I guess we don't have money troubles for a while. we probably could just go back to Kakariko Village and dump out our wallet, to keep going on that one side quest. Got more stuff we could do in Castletown, so we'll worry about that next episode. Got some more postals once again, so I think we're gonna end off the episode once we travel back north to this part of the Hyrule Field. I'll probably just hang around and wait till nighttime here, so we can get the postal here at the beginning of the next episode. But for now, though, we're going to call it a day. And say thanks for watching, and I hope to see you guys next time for some more side quests and minigames and, well, just side content in general. And hopefully we'll get most of it done before we proceed on with the story, which hopefully will be two episodes from now. So yeah, we're going to end off a few things here and try and grab the Poe that's going to be on this bridge here at the start of the next episode. So see you guys then. Oh, the storm's coming back too. And I keep sidetracking myself, so ending the episode right here, right now!